Home Assistant is the most powerful home automation tool that allows you to control your smart devices. It connects with everything, starting from your smart switches to your smart garage door openers, and it allows you to create customized automations with them. The best part about Home Assistant is it gives you the control, not any random IoT company. I don't want to control my devices through any random IoT company's cloud server, so that they can hack my data in minutes. The Home Assistant keeps everything locally. So that means all the data is in my hand and I have the full access over the data of my house. I'm not gonna say it is easy to install, but that's why RoboCircuits is for. RoboCircuits makes hard things easy for you. RoboCircuits brings you awesome tutorial like this on the fields like IoT, drones and robotics. So, if you haven't subscribed to RoboCircuit Sets, then go and subscribe. Before going forward in this video, let's see who is the sponsor of this video. This video is sponsored by the most advanced industry level electronic design automation software for printed circuit boards, LTM Designer. With LTM Designer comes Octopart, a powerful search engine that makes it fast and easy to compare millions of components, find important technical details, make component selection decision easy, and order components from the distributors. Octopart combines easily with LTM Designer to make your PCB designing journey smooth. If you go to the link in the description, you will get a free trial of LTM Designer with LTM 365 and 25% off on your purchase. So let's check what we need to start building a great smart home. Home Assistant can be installed on many devices, such as personal computers, NAS storages, and many other devices. But the most affordable way is to use a Raspberry Pi. It is preferable because of its small and compact size, as well as its ability to save your electricity. But which Pi is good enough? The recommended selection for Home Assistant is a Raspberry Pi 4, with minimum 4GB of RAM. But a Raspberry Pi 3 can also work, but with some limitations actually. And currently I am using a Raspberry Pi 8GB because I have it. To install Home Assistant, we need a SSD. But why SSD? Because Home Assistant can burn through SD cards like Marvel movies burn through DC fans. To use SSD with the Raspberry Pi, we need a SSD to USB case, something like this, and then it can be plugged easily in the Raspberry Pi. But with this much power, the Raspberry Pi will get heated up soon. So we need a good aluminium case for our Raspberry Pi so that it can be cooled easily. I went with this aluminium case. It has two DC fans on top of it to keep the Raspberry Pi cooling all time. Then it comes with thermal heat pads also. So first of all, we have to apply the thermal heat pads on the chips of the Raspberry Pi. Then we have to assemble the case and screw the case from the bottom. After that, we have to put both the DC fans on the top and screw them tight. Now, in order to run those DC fans, there is a pin which comes with it, and we have to plug it in the GPIO pins of the Raspberry Pi, to the red wire to the 5V and the black wire to the ground. Now, for this much potential of the Raspberry Pi, we need a good power supply. A minimum of 5 volts, 3 ampere power supplies is recommended for this type of setup. These power supplies are not easy to find, but I will give the link in the description of this video for such a power supply. And currently I am going with this one. It has the same ability of 15 watts. Then in order to connect our home assistant to our local network, we need an Ethernet cable so that we can connect our Raspberry Pi to our home router. Then finally, the final thing that we need is a SD card. But why SD card? We are already using a SSD. You will come to know about this in the next part of the video. In the next part, we will see how we can burn the home assistant software on the SSD and then how we can run that software on a Raspberry Pi. And finally, we will check out all the configuration steps that we need to start working on the home assistant. So let's jump to the second part. The links to the second part will be given in the description or something right here.